So while the ability to quickly and seamlessly remove obstacles from our photos in Lightroom is getting better and better with the gender remove tool, there are some instances where you may need some more heavy lifting. In those situations, turning to Photoshop opens up some seriously cool tools that makes distraction removal seem effortless. But there are a few best practices and settings that you'll want to be aware of to ensure that you get optimal results, and I'll show you what those are. But before we begin, I want to point out that the tools I'm going to show you in this video are powered by AI, and I know that there are photographers who have strong opinions both in support of and against this technology. If you're on the fence or you have strong feelings against AI, I recommend at least watching this video to see the capabilities that these particular tools offer. Whether or not you choose to use them with your photos is completely up to you, but I think it's at least wise to have a good idea of the capabilities that these tools offer so that you can make a more informed decision. All right, let's dive in. All right, so here we are in Photoshop. In this specific version, we are in Photoshop 2025. The tools that I'm going to show you, they were in Photoshop beta, but they have since been promoted to the public version of Photoshop 2025. And this is all about removing distractions. And honestly, one of these tools in particular absolutely positively blows my mind. And so this is the kind of thing where, again, if you're maybe on the fence with AI or you're just not really feeling it, when you see this, I mean, for me, what this can do is amazing. So instead of just kind of talking about it, let me show it to you. All right, so here I've got five different photos and I grabbed these off of a stock site and they do a great job of illustrating the tool. So you can see this is a photo taken down a city street. And one of the things that for me is most distracting are all of these wires and cables. They're just an eyesore. I understand the utility of them. In terms of here, they probably power some sort of a train or a bus or something, but they're just an eyesore. So if you have Photoshop 2025, what you're going to do is you're going to go to your remove tool, which is right here, and it's the J key on your keyboard. And what you want to make sure of is that you are on the remove tool. So if you press and hold on this icon, you don't want to be on spot healing. You want to be on remove tool. So here, there is this dropdown. You can see right here, it says find distractions. It's this button. When you click on it, you have two options. One-click removal for wires and cables, and then editable people. And I'm going to show you how both of these work here. So a few of the settings that I recommend to enable or at least to look at are you want to make sure that you have sample all layers selected. I think by default, this might be off. So I would turn this on. Part of the reason is, for each of these images, the first thing that I like to do is duplicate the layer. So I'm going to right click here, select duplicate layer. You can also press Command or Control J. But now we have basically a copy of our background layer. Another thing that I recommend is you'll see this mode dropdown. And by default, I believe it's on auto, which says may use generative AI. Honestly, I don't want to not use generative AI for these tools. So I turn that on here from auto to generative AI on. That way I know it's using it. And then an option that I recommend turning off is this remove after each stroke. This will come into play later on in this video, but I like to have that off. All right, so we want to get rid of these wires. So what do we do? Well, we're just going to go click on find distractions and then let's click on wires and cables. And then, I mean, I'm honestly, every time I look at this demo, I'm always just amazed. Like, watch this. If we toggle before and after, it's just amazing. And so to me, this is just one of those things where the AI technology, as it gets better, and it will get better, these kinds of tasks, they are, for me, one of the things that makes me absolutely miserable when it comes to photo editing. I don't even think about the possibility of removing like wires or cables because it's such a tedious process. But as you can see here, I think it does a really good job. Now, I'm not going to pretend like it's absolutely perfect. You know, like over here, you can see, watch, if I turn off this layer, you know, it did a kind of a hard job over here with the street lamp, but you can still work on this. Like, you can still use generative AI to fix these or to remove these. Point is, though, if I didn't bring that up, I would be willing to bet that most people would never even know or pay attention to that. And that's, I think, also a really important point. Like, yeah, if you want to pixel peep and stuff, by all means, go for it. But in these situations here, pretty much the only places that I share my photos are either on my website or on social media, usually like Instagram. And most of the time, people are just watching it on their tiny little displays here. I mean, they're not so tiny, but they are small. No one would notice this. So take everything in perspective and in context of the ultimate application of the photo. So here again, you know, I could give you this. I can share this with these kind of ugly wires. And yes, those street lamps, which are already obstructed, are there. Or I can give this to you here, which, I mean, I would never notice this. So let's move on. I have another example. Again, I like the shot. Again, I found this photo also on a stock site. And these wires just kill me. Like, they're just so atrocious. So let's go ahead here. Again, I'm going to press Command J or Control J on Windows, duplicate the layer. Let's go to Find Distractions and click on Wires and Cables. And again, I'm just absolutely positively floored at how good this is. Like, again, whether you like AI or hate it, you cannot deny the fact that this is really cool stuff. So again, all these ugly wires are gone. Super cool. Now, I have this example here because while the wire and cable removal is really good, you kind of have to be aware of kind of the context of your photo. So watch, let's go ahead, duplicate the layer one more time. Let's click on wires and cables. And so you can see, I mean, Photoshop did a bang up job. I mean, it got rid of those wires, but notice how you have these utility poles. I mean, they're here, but there's nothing connecting to them. So that's what I mean where, you know, here, it kind of makes sense because the wires are all connecting these poles together. But when you remove them, it does look kind of weird. So you could use some additional generative AI to kind of get rid of this stuff if you want, but just something to consider again when you are removing wires. All right, now let's move on to the other distraction option, and that's people. So here, I found this photo. I kind of dig it. It's got this kind of like Harry Potter preppy golfer vibe going on. But let's say I just want our kind of faux Harry Potter over here. I don't want the person behind him. Well, now what we can do is we can go to Find Distractions, and I'm just going to click on People. And you can see that Photoshop basically found the selection of this person. And here's another setting that I recommend. If you go to the gear here, by default, I think it's magenta is the default color. And also the opacity, I think, is 25%. I can't really see magenta, so I change it to yellow and I set it to 35%. It just makes it a lot easier for me to see that. So I recommend that as well. Again, it's accessible from this little gear icon over here. So all I did was I clicked on Find Distractions and People. And actually, let me deselect this. I'm going to undo this really quickly because of what I want to do is I actually want to duplicate the layer. I forgot to do that. Now let's go ahead, select People. But I don't need to make any modifications. I'll show you what that's like in the next image. But by default, Photoshop selection is spot on. I'm going to go ahead and click on this little check mark right there. And boom, our golfing Harry Potter character is by himself. So you can see here, really nice job there. All right, let's move on to our final image here. So this is one of those kind of photographer inception photos where a photographer is taking a photo of another photographer who's taking a photo. So, you know, I like this photo, but let's say, you know, I want to get rid of these two people over here that are walking out of the frame. Otherwise, I like the photo. So let's go ahead. We'll duplicate our layer. Just like before, we're going to go to Find Distractions and select People. And so Photoshop does a really good job of identifying the people. I didn't have to do anything, but there's a little tiny thing, and this is super, super important. In fact, if you watch my previous video, which I'll link to at the end of this one, I go into some of the best practices to get great results using generative remove in Lightroom. And one of them is right here that I can show you. You can see right down here, you see how Photoshop got most of the shadow, but there's that little bit right there that it didn't get. That is super important. If you're removing a person and that person is casting a shadow, you want to make sure that you get that entire shadow in your selection. And so you can see here, we have the ability to paint in and paint out. So by painting in, you just start painting in it. That's the default mode. So I'm going to go ahead here and I'm just going to include the full shadow there. So now the full selection is made. And while we're at it, I also want to remove this stuff here, this little garbage can and this little water pipe. So I'm going to just make my selection of all of this. This shadow is fine because it's being cast by the column over here, but I want to make sure that I get all of this. And then let's say I also, you know, say I want to remove this, and then I have a change of heart. Well, you can paint out either by clicking on the minus button here, or if you press and hold on the option key on Mac or Alt on Windows, you can see how the icon changes from a plus to a minus. And then I can just remove that stroke that I just made if I had, like I said, a change of heart, or if you want to refine the selection. Maybe, you know, I went a bit too far this way and I actually want to kind of tighten that up, something like that. All right, so now we've made our selections. Let's go ahead and click on the check mark over here. And there we go. The people are gone, as are their shadows. And this area here is clear. You can see just how much better it is. Just more of a cleaner photo. All right, so that is how you can use these AI-powered distraction removal tools in Photoshop. Again, especially the wires and cables, it is something else. And like I said, it's gonna get better and better as the AI models improve. If you're not into it, I get it. But at the very least now, you know that maybe there is a photo that you really just wanted to do something with, but it had too many wires, for example. Now at least you know that there is a tool available and it's just one click and it'll get rid of them for you. And so you can make a more informed decision, maybe not using AI for every photo, but on certain photos, you know that the tool's there and you know how to use it. And that is, I would say, one of the best things that someone who's against AI, I would hope, could walk away from watching this video. Now, I know that this video is all about Photoshop, but I also have plenty of videos on Lightroom. And if you want to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom, I have a very in-depth course called Lightroom Everywhere. It's got almost 11 hours of easy-paced lessons, and it'll teach you absolutely everything you would need to know about Lightroom desktop, mobile, and web. I'll leave a link below to check it out. I also mentioned that I have this video here, which will explain how to get the best results using generative remove in Lightroom. So check that out. And if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is very much appreciated. And be sure to click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.